What's up, Powerhouse?
I'm here with Kaylee and Titan, and we're here to bring you the continuing series on the bugs. Now, Kaylee, are you ready for this?
I think I'm ready.
It's pretty creepy. And Crawly, are you ready, Titan?
I think so.
I'm not ready. It's about the spider. It's so gross, the legs, but we're learning about it because guess what? It's doing some pretty cool stuff and we're gonna learn what not to do. Wait, hold on. Where did this thing come from? Okay guys, so I got this popsicle here. Now, this could look really good, but let's pretend like this is really bad and we're supposed to stay away from it. Now, this is cold and the flavor, and on a hot day too. But sometimes with temptation, it can look really good, but it's actually bad for us. We need to stay away from it. We need to resist from it, even if it looks good. So, I don't want to be around this. Here, I gotta go.
Ooh, this is mine.
Give it to me.
Game on. Hey, boys and girls, it's game time. Now listen in. Very special instructions. Listen up.
Hey, boys and girls. Today, we are playing Two Truths and One Lie. Play along with Patrick Joey and see if you can spot the lie. Here we go.
Patrick Joey, two truths and one lie. Here we go. Letter A, there are 66 books in the Bible. Letter B, there are 27 books in the New Testament. Or letter C, there are 35 books in the Old Testament. Which is a lie?
There are 66 books in the Bible. There are 27 books in just the New Testament, so it must be letter C. That's the lie.
You are correct.
Pastor Joey, two truths and one lie. Letter A, there were many authors, all inspired by the Holy Spirit. Letter B, Paul wrote the entire Bible. Or letter C, some authors wrote more than one book of the Bible. Which is the lie?
This is tough. The Holy Spirit did inspire the writers to write the Bible. There were many authors that wrote the Bible, so it has to be letter B. Paul did not write all the Bible.
You're correct. Paul did not write the entire Bible. Pastor Joey, two truths and one lie. Letter A, the first book of the Old Testament is Exodus. Letter B, the first book of the New Testament is Matthew. Or letter C, the last book of the Bible is Revelation. Which is the lie?
What do you think, boys and girls? I think the lie is letter A. The first book of the Bible is not Exodus.
You are correct. Pastor Joey, two truths and one lie. Letter A, the Bible is divided into chapters and verses. Letter B, some verses are repeated in the Bible. Or letter C, the book of Isaiah is the longest in the Bible. Which is the lie?
This is a tough one. I believe that the lie is letter C.
You are correct. Pastor Joey, two truths and one lie. Letter A, God created the heavens and the earth. Letter B, God created light on the third day. Or letter C, God created mankind on the sixth day. Which is the lie?
Let's see here. That's a nail breaker. Do you guys know the answer? I want to say that it's letter B. That's the lie.
You are correct. God did not create light on the third day. Hey, boys and girls. Good job playing along with Patrick Joe. We'll get him next time.
Hi, boys and girls. This is Miss Bonnie from second grade small group. Today, we're talking about the spider.
Hello, boys and girls. What's up? This is Miss Nurley from the first grade power cell, and I have...
Michael from first grade.
And...
Lynn from elementary.
Hi, boys and girls. How many of you have a favorite superhero?
Today, we're talking about the spider.
Lots of you know my son, Joe Martin, and Joe Martin's favorite superhero has always been Spider-Man. When you think of Spider-Man, you think of webs. Today, we are not talking about Spider-Man.
So anytime someone asks you what's up, you tell them,
hey, what's up?
I will avoid
the web of temptation.
The web of temptation.
I will avoid the web of temptation.
Spiders try to capture stuff in their web.
And Satan likes to catch us and trap us.
A web of sin with temptation.
The devil will try anything to lure you into his web of sin.
He will do anything he can to lure you into that web.
He might tempt you to lie and get out of trouble.
Liar, liar, pants on fire.
He might tempt you to cheat on a test.
Or he might even try to tempt you to steal something.
Don't give into that temptation. Do not get caught in that web.
Turn around and run the other direction.
If somebody says to you, hey, what's up?
You tell them,
I will avoid the web of temptation.
I will avoid the web of temptation.
I will avoid the web of temptation.
And that right there
is what's up.
I miss you, and I cannot wait to be together again. I hope you have a happy summer. Enjoy your vacation. Don't forget to read a book or two while you are enjoying the nice weather outside.
You guys, I miss you so much. I can't wait to see you again. I pray for you. I love you so much. Bye.
We're praying for you. A lot. And my mother's praying for you too.
Hey everybody, it's your bug-loving friend Mosquito here, and this might be a rough day for my video demonstration of my game Splat. I'm gonna let you in on a little secret. My state-of-the-art, technologically advanced bug catchers are really Tupperware from my mom's pantry. And see, we're going on a picnic later today, and when she discovered that all our Tupperware was gone, she wasn't too happy. So, I've been working on a solution to use something else to catch the bugs. So far, it's not really worked. I tried books. Oh, where is it? Ew. I also tried using some of my mom's shirts. Anything, I've been getting a good workout running from my mom. Who's Beetle? Oh, it's my cousin Brandon. Hey, maybe he can come over and be my bug containers. Oh, he said yes. I didn't even text him back. Oh well, that's great, now we can go catch. I'm here with my cousin Beetle and we're gonna catch some bugs. Oh, I think I see some movement. You know what that means? Gotta catch them all! Entirely. Wow, that's so brave that you just catch the bugs in your hands like that.
It's really nothing. As long as it's not a spider. I absolutely hate spiders.
Oh.
What?
It's a spider. Don't worry, y'all. I got it. Here, let me get my bug guide out and look up some facts. Let's see. Spiders have 8 legs, more than 2 eyes, and they eat bugs. That's right, they eat bugs. Spiders are predators, which means they are hunters. It kind of reminds me how the devil traps us in his web, and he uses temptation to trap us. But there's a lot of ways we can avoid these webs, and that's what you're gonna learn about in your lesson today. It's gonna be amazing. Well, before I go, I guess I should at least try to eat the spider. What? Oh, sorry. My mom's calling me. I've got to run. I guess I'll eat the spider next time or never. See you later.
I can't handle it. Here, you have it.
Thank you.
Hey, boys and girls. Joe Martin for another week of...
Joey, do it! Help me get like a spider! This spider is...
Okay, hey. Dad, I'm trying to tell the Bible story to the kids right now.
I know, but I got a spider on me.
There's no spider on you. You're okay. Promise? Yeah, I promise.
Sorry about that, boys and girls. Back to our another amazing Bible story for this week. Today, our story is found in the book of Matthew, chapter 4. This story is about something that happened to Jesus. Jesus went off by himself into the wilderness to pray and fast for 40 days and 40 nights. Fasting means that he didn't eat. Can you imagine not eating anything for 40 days? I'm sure he was extremely hungry. Well, as Jesus was there in the wilderness, guess who shows up? None other than the devil himself. He came to try to tempt Jesus to sin. He came and said to Jesus, "If you are the Son of God, change these stones into loaves of bread." But Jesus told him, "No, the scriptures say people need more than bread for their life. They must feed on every word of God." Pretty smart of Jesus, huh? He went straight to the scriptures and told Satan what God's word says. Then the devil took him to Jerusalem, to the highest point of the temple, and said, "If you are the Son of God, jump off. Everyone knows that God will send his angels to protect you." Jesus responded, "The scriptures also say, do not test the Lord your God." Once again, Jesus goes right to the scriptures. He knew exactly what God's word says. And he reminded the devil that we shouldn't tempt God by doing dumb things like jumping off a building. Next, the devil took him to the peak of a very high mountain and showed him the nations of the world in all their glory. The devil told Jesus, "I will give it all to you if you will only kneel down and worship me." Jesus responded, "Get out of here, Satan. For the scriptures say, you must worship the Lord your God and serve him only." Yes, Jesus hits the devil with the word of God. The Bible tells us that right then, the devil went away. Jesus had defeated the devil with God's word. If the devil tried to trap Jesus with temptation, then there's no doubt that he is going to try to trap us. We must avoid Satan's web of temptation.
Hello, class. My name is Professor Busby McFly, and I am a bugologist, which means I study insects every day to determine what valuable lessons they might give us in order for us to become better Christians. Today's bug is the spider. Now, these creepy crawly creatures have the amazing ability to shoot silk out from their bodies and create webs. And in these webs, they can collect all sorts of things, like grasshoppers and butterflies and antique baseball cards and fortune cookies and basketballs. And sometimes, if they collect enough basketballs, then they can start their own NBA team. Really small courts, of course. You need magnifying glasses to watch it, but it's amazing. I think. Probably. I don't know. But what I do know is that the spider reminds me of today's power verse, which says, "Resist the devil, and he will flee from you." James 4:7. Bazinga! That power verse was superlative. Now, what I need is for all the boys to stand to their feet and say the power verse on the count of three. Ready? 1, 2, 3. Resist the devil, and he will flee from you. James 4:7. That was fantastic, boys. You may sit down. Now, all the girls stand to your feet and say the power verse on the count of three. Here we go. 1, 2, 3. Resist the devil, and he will flee from you. James 4:7. What an amazing power verse. You may be seated. Isn't it true? We must avoid at all costs the web of temptation. In fact, we should probably avoid spider webs altogether, because when you run into them, you look like a crazy person. Now, I need everyone to stand to their feet and say the power verse on the count of three. Ready? One, two, three. Resist the devil, and he will flee from you. James 4:7. Excellent job, everyone. You may be seated. Well, that's it for me. I'm back off to the lab to study another bug, while I'll be reading books like a bookworm and searching for articles on the worldwide spider web. Until next time, this is Professor Buzz B. McFly. Bye!
I know it doesn't belong to me, but it wouldn't hurt to just have a little bite, right?
Hey, boys and girls. Have you ever accidentally walked into a spider web? Ooh, yuck! They're sticky, they get all in your hair, they stick on your clothes, it just doesn't come off. Have you ever wondered why the spider web is so sticky? It's because the web is what the spider uses to catch the insect. Then the spider swoops in and eats the insect. Do you know that our enemy, you know, the devil, works much the same way? The Bible tells us that our enemy, the devil, has only three things on his mind. Number one, he wants to steal away our innocence. Number two, he wants to kill our hopes and our dreams. And number three, he wants to destroy our future. He tries to set up a trap for you and I to get us caught in sin. He knows that sin is the one thing God dislikes the most. That's why he tries to lay a web of temptation for us to try and trap us. The devil tries to trap us as well in hopes that we'll get caught. Not only does he want to trap us, but he knows how to trap us. He knows that you and I are only human, and he's been watching us. Been looking, and he knows what our weaknesses are. He's seen when we've messed up before. He knows what our weaknesses are. Maybe your weakness is lying. Maybe because you want people to think you're cool and you make up lies to tell them about yourself. Maybe your weakness is watching bad things on TV. Maybe your weakness is hanging around them with the wrong kids. Whatever your weakness is, the devil will try to use that weakness to lay out a web of temptation and try to trap us in our sin. Now, right now, I know most of you might be sitting there thinking, oh, Pastor Joey, this is so depressing. The devil wants to trap us, and he knows exactly how to trap us. What's the use? Well, that's where I'm here to give you some good news. Are you ready? Even though he really wants to trap us, and he knows exactly how to trap us, the devil can't trap us as long as you and I stay alert and are aware of his web of temptation. You see, our power verse today tells it all. James 4:7 says, if you and I will resist the devil, he will flee from us. Even if the devil tries to lay a web of temptation in front of us, as long as we resist that temptation and turn away, then we won't get caught in sin. You may be tempted, but you don't have to sin. All you have to do is tell that devil, hey, get out of here! And he has to run away. Boys and girls, can I pray for you right now? Would you please close your eyes and bow your heads and let's pray. Heavenly Father, I'm asking right now that you help all of us, the boys and girls and myself included, their moms and dads, to be strong and resist that devil's webs of temptation. Lord, I also want to pray for the boys and girls that maybe have given in to that temptation and they sinned and it's already led them astray. I pray right now, Lord, that as they are asking you for forgiveness, that you would forgive them according to your amazing love and the power and authority that you have. And Lord, I pray that you will help them to recognize where they're weak and where they need your strength to make them strong in those areas of weakness. And Lord Jesus, we'll give you all the praise and all the glory. And everyone in Powerhouse said, amen. Boys and girls, I love you. And we're really, really close to seeing each other again.
You guys, stop. What are y'all doing? Listen, it's all melted now. It's not even gonna be good.
We just learned. Stay away from temptation. You guys say that with me? Stay away from temptation. Man, that is a good lesson to learn because we're gonna see things and we'll be like, wow, maybe I should do that. No, that's what we should not do. If you see something bad, walk away. All right, so I don't really want this. This is like all melty. Let's go find something good, all right?
Okay. Yeah.
All right, see you guys next week.
Everything.